I learned New York's rules like I learned my mother's. Knew where not to go, what not to say, when to ditch the joint, when to hold, when to hop in the subway car, when to hop out. Second Avenue is my scene. Sleazy, even in daylight. Rough, raw, and loud. But Second wasn't first, wasn't A, B, or C. Safe enough, and we knew the tricks. The brisk stroll through the dark, the fast walk along the edge of the curb. Take that tunnel? Nope. Down that way? Not a chance. Keys stuck between the fingers, nail file at hand, can of Campbell's tomato in my purse. Anyone tries to yoke me, they get it fast. Wham bam, thank you ma'am. Better than a roll of quarters. A friend said a hose full of sand does the trick. Worked for him more than once. Back then, New York wasn't America. Fine with us. No life like New York life. Fueled on synapse and cigarette smoke, looking over your shoulder just to be sure. You hear a rat? Who's there at the end of the platform? What's that on the side of the street? Run, motherfucker, run! Beneath skies red with bronze Now, I'm a gal of experience, so let me tell it to you straight. It isn't all glory. New York is a wonder, even as it kills you. Life in New York is asthma. Life in New York is slow death. You live with it. You barely see the decay, the stone wearing away. I always felt safe at work. Good old Binibon. A waitress always finds work. I've waited with the best. And still in the game, a waitress dies from the feet up, like a tree with pissed on roots. I'll be here a long time still. I knew all the artists, knew all the musicians. Most of them gone now, one place or the other. One was genius. At least so I thought. The old shuck and jive, some said. But he had his visions and knew what he liked. A dealer in Soho, I heard, locked him in the basement with canvas and paint. Brown Mexican, China white. She hustled his work like a master. Fed him to Andy. He was around then, but not that night. At the sink with Keith, no doubt. If it feels good, he just couldn't say no. Everybody had that problem once. I had another friend at the time, my favorite, that's true. He had his own problems. I remember that night. He was there, too.
Then he'll also have a tale to tell.
He always did. He was with me for years. In spirit, if not in fact. He was an artist. Gave his life to his arts. But the one he was best at, I never want him to learn. He said life couldn't compare to what the other world holds, no matter who's in it, even me. Reefer's one thing, junk's another. He grew to love the feel of winter wrapping around his head, slumping heavy on his shoulders, the feel of slowly freezing, the feel there's no real point, the looking down from orbit. He mastered that particular art. And all that he had went straight up his arm.
Some here this evening passed on long ago to that big New York in the sky, where every store you remember will always be open, where there's always a seat on the six, where your friends will all be there with you. And so is the Third Avenue L. So get up here, Johnny. Feed us your line. Sometimes there's wisdom in the end of a needle. Sometimes not.
Susie, I'm sorry. It should have been different. If I had met you 6 months earlier, well, maybe 6 years. Hard to remember now. I'd still be in my apartment if my roommate hadn't fucked up. If my mom had just sent the money. If they hadn't canned me at work, I wouldn't have even been there, probably. Well, you do what you do when you can. It wasn't hard writing once I'd sit down and do it, but on slow days, a kicker always helped. A snort here, and then a shot, and then another, and then I'm 16 chapters behind, and it no longer matters. Susie, my sweetheart, things just fell into place. It was fate. It was kismet preordained from on high.